First up on The Beach Sessions, this newly formed Christian rock band credits their success to each other's diverse musical backgrounds. You'll meet All Above Me. This is All Above Me. Geezer, Britt, Tim, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Tim's the one who talks all the time.
That is not correct.
Actually, it's funny, because Tim, you actually have the probably the loudest instrument, the drums, and yet you're the quietest guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Britt, why is he so quiet?
I don't know.
Character flaw?
I think, with the drums being so loud all the time, I think he feels he needs to compensate.
It was maybe some fury is gone on him.
There you go. That must be it.
Sometimes he's loud when he's sleeping, because I'll be sleeping a lot next to him, and he'll talk once or twice. He was really talking in through the night.
Geezer, you're the dad. Dad of these two children.
Yes. I act more like the child, but I would say, when it comes to being serious, I'm the dad, yes.
Britt, if there's one thing about being in a band or something like this, you realize as much as you enjoy performing and as much as you enjoy the music, it's still a business.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
There's something about knowing that aspect of the business and realizing, okay, it's a job. We got to put our time in.
Yep.
True?
Mm-hmm,
and
absolutely.
You three do that, yes?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now that we've had some downtime. Well, not downtime. We're very busy, just not traveling. So we've been writing new music. And usually I would write all the songs and have them ready, put a demo, and they kind of learn it. But now now Tim and I started working on all of our new stuff together. And it's incredible because he's a very good drummer and he's very technical.
Right, right.
And I like that, but I never had the education to get there. Mm. So I'm kind of bringing the catchy ideas and melodies, and he's bringing the kind of the more metal roots.
So Tim, you're helping Dad.
Yeah.
You're helping him out. This is awesome, man.
Oh, yeah.
I love it.
Big time.
But Britt, did you know that Christian rock was the avenue that you wanted to go down?
Oh, absolutely. Yes. Yeah.
So well before this was all coming together, because you joined late mm-hmm. into the band. You and Tim actually joined late.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What did you say to Tim? It's like, hey, you want to do this? Or did you think about maybe other genres like pop music? Or?
Tim had joined. He joined a little before me, a couple weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah. And so Geezer was then looking for a vocalist. Tim goes, Britt could probably do
pull it.
He knows that, I love Christian rock. And, when I was graduating high school, people would say to me, what do you want to be when you grow up? Well, I want to be a Christian rock star.
Did you really say that?
I did.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. And here you are.
Yeah,
and it's all you ever wanted and more.
It is, yep.
Wow.
And she's here because Tim directed me to her, basically. Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, Britt is really like rock. Like, she likes hard rock. She's very heavy music. You wouldn't believe it, but she likes really heavy stuff. So
yeah, he couldn't believe it. He's like, "Do you really like this music?" Yes, I love metal. Yeah. Love it.
Wow.
Yeah, and where I grew up on pop. That was what I was really raised on is pop. And so I love metal, but that's why I was, all I know, like musically, that I was good at was pop. So I knew I wanted to go more metal and hard rock. And
wonderful.
And it was great to have her with that love of the heavy stuff too. Mm-hmm. So
Tim, this young man is wearing a shirt that says hope less. And the word less, it's the Joyful Project. What do you know about the Joyful Project? Or what should we know about it?
It's a company that we got connected with through a festival we played at. And basically they wanted to partner with us so we could advertise their clothing. And so what they do is they partner with some organizations in India that actually...
Freeset, they're called.
Yeah, Freeset Global, I think, is what it's called. And so basically they support... they're trying to get women out of the sex trade there. So what they do is provide jobs for them and pay them a good salary. And train them to basically make clothes, and the Joyful Project makes all the designs and everything like that. Mm-hmm. So it's like a practical way to get women out of the sex trade. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Good for you guys. Well done. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. And it's been great. Like, they they're a new company they just launched this year, and you know, they're growing and growing, and they saw us at a festival and like our message, and right. So they want to work with people that kind of have the same message. So obviously we looked into it, and we love what they're doing, and we believe in supporting that. So it just worked out perfectly to help each other.
Love it.
So
you're singing a song for us, you three. Which song do you have in mind, Geezer?
We're going to be singing a song called King and Crown, which is going to be our next single that we're going to be releasing.
Okay. Which is, what's the song about?
This song is about dealing with demons inside of you. And this song talks about just all your struggles that you're dealing with, whether it's, you know, addiction or just thoughts of suicide or whatever you know you're struggling with. At the end, it shows that there is hope. Mm. And a lot of people can interpret the song in different ways. In our case, it's hope in Jesus Christ is what we believe in. So yeah, that's what this song talks about. And we're currently in the studio working on this song. And when we release it, which will be hopefully early next year, we're going to have a singer from a band called Disciple. They're a big Christian hard rock band out of the U.S.
Nice.
He's going to be screaming onto this song.
Wow.
So we're very excited for that. We're going to be shooting a music video in January and stuff.
Fantastic.
And so, yeah, we're very excited for it.
Excited to hear it as well, too. Mm-hmm. This is All Above Me.
still to come on the Beach Sessions. They've been described as a groove backbeat-oriented project with contemporary original content and a variety of timeless influences. You'll meet the Rondel Roberts Band.
This is the Rondel Roberts Band. Who's Rondel? I'm kidding. It's not this guy over here. It's Brad. It's Jamil. Rondel. Who are the two people behind us?
It's Colin, Chanel, my sister. I bring her everywhere I go, pretty much.
Do you really? Come on
now. No, not really. I wish she could come. But
you know what? Actually, you guys, about 5 years ago, the way that Jamil tells the story is that you were in a bar somewhere. Was it a bar or restaurant?
We were at a bar playing a gig. We were in a different band. He was playing keyboard. I was playing guitar. And we got bored, so we went outside and grabbed an acoustic guitar and just started playing. Right. And then everybody from inside kind of came outside and kind of started watching us. And we're like, yeah, we're kind of onto something.
You are kidding me.
Yeah.
There's instant chemistry for sure. Yeah. That was my first experience in music, pretty much in general, in a public sense.
Yeah.
I spent a lot of time growing up doing a lot of more athletic endeavors, so it was a unique experience for me.
So who kicked you, man, and said, look, this is something you gotta do? Were you just like in the shower and your sister came by and said, man?
Nobody, my shoulder hurt, my hamstrings hurt, yeah. So something else to do. So that's pretty much how, and it kind of grew from there. And
yeah.
Calgary was a fertile ground for me to, let's say, explore that side of myself.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
So you say to yourself, I got Jamil, I got myself, I got my sister who can do decent backup singing.
Well, yeah.
And you figured, well, I got to bring in some other folks here. So you bring everybody else together, and all of a sudden something happens.
Jamil was a big driving force in terms of getting it together, getting people together. And a real 21st century story, like Kijiji, we're looking for someone to play bass.
Okay, hold on. Yeah. I love this story. So, Brad, what's the deal? Tell us about your world before this band.
Well, I moved to Calgary 5.5 years ago, and I just put an ad on Kijiji saying, I play bass, I want to play in a rock band, I like Radiohead. And I get an email from Jamil over here. Yeah. It's like, I've got this neo-soul jazz funk thing going. I was like, well, it's nothing like I described in my post, but I did grow up like playing funk and all this stuff, so it was actually a really good place for me to get way better at playing that type of music.
So this rock guy, Jamil, comes walking in the door who loves to play bass, and you're saying, okay, I don't know if this is gonna work. How did all that happen?
Ooh, I'd like to hear this story.
Oh, yeah, no. What was your first impression?
Yeah, there you go.
Well, I want to hear this.
A little bit more. We actually used him for like this wedding band that we were kind of like trying with a different artist, and when I heard him kind of play like these wedding songs that we're doing with Rika, if you remember, he could boogie, and I was like, yeah, you're hired, because we were only four people, so the idea was to find somebody that can play with a lot of personality, because when you're a four piece, it's not just about, the vocals. It's, you're getting four different personalities, because that's the only sonic information you're getting, and that's why it was a matter of getting the person with the right attitude and the right style, sort of the same way.
Yeah. Look at this, man. Right attitude and style.
For me, it's like when he first started playing with this guy, like he closed his eyes, moves around. Like that's it's very important.
Yeah.
Energy. So like.
Look at that.
He definitely has the energy, and so that definitely worked pretty much right away too, for sure.
So you're taking this music, and you're doing something with it, and it's working. You guys obviously have an appreciation for each other.
Yeah.
Where are you going with this thing, man?
We're friends. World tours, millions of dollars.
Like, hey, don't laugh, Brett. I've had a lot of people who sit in these seats, and they're taking their career in directions that they never even imagined.
I think that we're becoming more comfortable with the idea of maybe doing more with it. So definitely try and make a push towards
beyond.
Sharing what we have with
good for you.
With the masses, I guess you'd say.
Hey, you know what? You're singing for us. What are you going to be singing, and what's the song about?
I think we're going to sing Do I Gotta Say. It's a love song. It's like pretty much
a sincere love song.
Someone
from your past.
Losing their pride in order to, like, the last ditch, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? Like, you talk to the girl, but you, like, try to... But then there's a point where you're like, please. Please, baby, please. That's where we're at.
Cannot wait. Great talking to all of you.
Yes,
next time we'll get you two on mics. The Rondel Roberts Band.
Chase after everything, baby. There ain't no need to be mean, girl. I just wanna be seen, heard. 'Cause you're the only thing that's on my mind, yeah. You make up your mind, yeah, 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 baby. 'Cause first you want this, and then you want that, and then you want me, and then you want Jay. Why don't you let me know, baby? Got to say, yo, do what got to say, yeah, do what got to say, me, yeah. Do what gotta get down on my knees and beg and beg for your love, yeah, yeah. Do what got to say, yo, do what got to say, yeah, do what got to say, me. Got to do for your love, yeah. You we'll be right back.
yeah. Do what God say, be here. Do what gotta get down on my knees and beg and beg for your love. Do what God say, no. Do what God say, yeah. Do what God say, be. And do for your love. What do I got to do to get some of your love
here? Still to come on the Beach Sessions. An auspicious start to this pairing, thanks to an unlikely source, Kijiji. You'll hear and meet Hayden and Craig.
This is Hayden and Craig.
Hi.
Ghost, Mustang.
Yeah.
High River, Calgary. But you've only been together for a year.
Yes.
And who would have thought that here you guys are so far apart would come together because of Kijiji?
Yeah.
What's the story, Craig?
Well, I basically finished doing production school here and went on Kijiji looking for clients to build up my repertoire so that I can get a portfolio going to do my own production work, I guess.
Yep.
So Hayden was actually the first guy who got in touch with me.
Super on top of it.
Yeah.
Man, hey?
Yeah, yeah. Maybe he could tell the rest, I think.
Basically, yeah. So essentially what ended up happening is Craig was offering to come into your home and to record a song for you. And that was really interesting I was something I was really interested in because it was kind of the moment where I started to realize that I needed to build up a little bit of some official recordings if I was actually going to get my music out there. So he came over, we recorded one of the first songs I ever released, California, and it kind of just went up from there. Craig really enjoyed recording with me, so he just decided to help me record a whole studio album.
Isn't that something? Yeah. So a rock guy gets together with this guy who's kind of a pop. Would that be fair?
Yeah.
Was that a tough struggle for both of you? Because you didn't quite click in the sense of musical clicks?
Yeah.
Was it tough at first, or?
I would say sometimes, you know, there's definitely a moment where for example, we've got one song that's on the album called Wild Ones, and it's definitely a little bit more, I almost wrote like a pop rock metal song almost, very, very pop, but a little bit on the metal side, and Craig got at it, and he was kind of adding some of the drums and stuff like that, and it was coming out a little aggressive and hard.
So
just in a couple moments like that, where we had to be like, okay, like, let's tone down the metal a little bit, remember we're making some metal, and in my sense too, sometimes I had to give up on, like, I wanted these, like, dance drums almost on the Wild Ones track, and it doesn't necessarily fit like that because it's more of a rock song, so you need to kind of give it up a little bit and allow him to do a little bit of what he does best to be able to make it sound the better.
I'd say
the best, I guess.
For what we both bring to the table, it makes it very unique anyways. Mm-hmm. It's a very unique sound.
And that's what leads me into my next point, because if there's anything about Hayden and Craig that you'll realize real fast is that they are trying to create a new genre of music. Now, either both of you or one of you want us to jump in and please explain, what do you mean by a new genre of music?
Well, I would say that we're just trying to shift kind of the way that pop music is kind of going. And I feel like a lot of people say that, but I love pop music. I've been listening to it my whole life. Like, I grew up on all the random, like, Britney Spears and the big pop artists and all that stuff. And I really kind of, they grew for like an emotional attachment to the way that they have it. And there's a bunch of different genres that inspire me, things like hip hop to big festival dance music to even like acoustic, almost like classical music really inspires me as well. And choral, I was in a choir or a show choir for 12 years. So I'm really familiar with very classical pieces as well. And I kind of feel like the music that I create and that we've created together has been this really cool smash of all these kind of inspirations of hip hop and classical music and choir performance. I love to do big harmonies on top of all of the tracks and stuff. And
wow.
Yeah, it's been really cool.
The song you're singing for us, what is it?
So this is a song I wrote about a year ago called Black Widow.
It's called Black Widow.
Yeah, it's the one that I produced originally. So a lot of the music that I write is produced. The album that's been released this year is acoustic. So we've done the whole album acoustically. I felt like I wanted to use that not only for my own personal music, but also I want to be a songwriter as well. So to use that to send to other artists so they could be interested in maybe potentially having me write songs with them. But usually we do it with production. It's a little bit more poppy. It's got the, I don't know, the whole setup in the background, basically.
Sure, sure.
And so this song I wrote, I really like hip hop, but I really don't like rap. So I tried to kind of like write a little bit of a hip hop song with a little bit of a pop kind of twist on it. It's called Black Widow, so you can kind of give you a little...
And then we made it acoustic.
Yeah, and then we made it acoustic. It's called Black Widow, so you can kind of get a good idea of what it's about. Essentially, a couple of years ago, I was with somebody and they were neglecting to let me know that while they started seeing me, they had been seeing somebody for like 2 years, and he had gone away on vacation. And they weren't letting me know, and I was a little frustrated about that, so the idea just kind of came about, and
here's the song.
And here's the song,
Okay, we're gonna have a listen to this. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
This is Hayden and Craig.
I know where you go when you go out at night, but I know you just don't care. I know that you've been sleeping with him and he don't know I'm here. He knows you love him so. And now I'm trying to prove that I'm stronger than you, but you seem to catch me every single time. And now I'm hoping maybe this time that I could wish you to say goodbye. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. You never been one to say goodbye. I thought I'd give it a try to try and change you, but all I got was maybe you think that I'm a fool, but I'm starting to believe it too. I know that I should go. Whoa, how many others have you trapped inside your web? Oh no, you don't do this often. No, you don't go walk on the dark side. But now I'm trying to prove that I'm stronger than you, but you seem to catch me every single time. And now I'm hoping maybe this time that I could wish you to say goodbye. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. You never been one to say goodbye. I thought I'd give it a try to try and change you, but all I got was time. I always thought that I knew better. No, I always knew that I would fall. But now I'm hoping maybe this time that I can say goodbye. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. Cause you're a Black Widow, baby. You never been one to say goodbye. I thought I'd give it a try to try and change you, but all I got was time. Yeah.